Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making bananas foster, and this is going to be a wonderful dessert that is dramatic and it tastes really great. So we're going to start with some butter. I've already put a half a stick of salted butter in this skillet. You can use unsalted if you prefer. A half stick is the same as 1/4 cup. Now we're going to put in some brown sugar. This is light brown sugar, and I have measured out 3/4 of a cup. Now some of you ask about this utensil, and I had used it for peanut butter pudding, and I had pushed the peanut butter through. This is just a measuring cup, and it's used for dry measures if you hold it one way, and it's used for liquid measures if you hold it upside down from the other way. So I've got it positioned where this is 3/4 of a cup, so I can just put 3/4 of a cup of brown sugar in and just pour it out. It's not necessarily a push-through thing, unless in the case of this, I guess it can be, because that's packed brown sugar. So that goes in with our melted butter. We'll come back to that and stir it up in just a second. I have also cinnamon. Now I've measured out 2 teaspoons. This is in a tablespoon measure, but it's not full. It's 2 teaspoons of ground cinnamon. So put that in. And then you'll notice over here, the last ingredient is bananas. This is just a couple of show bananas for you, but there are 4 of them in here that I have sliced up. And I've been keeping some lemon juice on them to keep them fresh. So if you have to work ahead and let them sit, you might want to do that. Otherwise, you don't need to worry about it. Now this has sat long enough that I can stir it around and it should be about ready to come together. So we're going to take it to the stove and just heat that up a little bit. It's just a matter of combining these, and then we're going to add some liquid. After bringing my mixture over to the stove, you can see that it's all come together, and I'm going to add the bananas. So our 4 sliced bananas get added in. And we want the bananas coated with this mixture. And turn that down just a little bit. Take my time in getting them coated. I'd like for all of them to have a little bit of coating on them. This is going to be delicious when you see the final dish. But when you get to a point somewhere about like this, and you have it over medium heat, you're going to pour some liquor in. And that is liquor of your choice, which could be something like banana liqueur, or you can use a combination of that and rum, or you can use just rum. And what I'm going to do is use this golden rum. I have 1/4 cup measured right here, and I'm waiting just a little bit for these bananas to be warm all the way through. They were cool when I put them in, and they have to take on the heat of that sauce. But in just a second, I'm going to pour in my liquor, and then it may flame on its own, but if not, we're going to have it along with the butane lighter. So here goes. We have 1/4 cup of golden rum. Just pour that over the top, and then you'll see it sizzle. But that is a flame that you'll let go on for just a little bit, and then you'll extinguish it. I'm going to turn this off. Actually, we're through with that. And the flame has gone out, and we have this nice, lovely sauce. And here's what we're going to do with it. We're going to come over to our serving place, where I have gotten out some vanilla ice cream. We have 3 scoops of vanilla ice cream, and you can do this however you like. You can put this over to the side if you like. It's a nice saucy sauce. Or you can just put it down in the middle and let it melt some of your ice cream. It's really a wonderful sauce. I think you'll enjoy the flavor. You can just use rum flavoring if you don't approve of using an alcohol of any sort. However, the alcohol evaporates and is gone. It's not really an alcoholic beverage at that point. So, in case you wondered, it's not alcoholic at all when you serve it up like this. Hope you enjoy the Bananas Foster.